So friends, I am Professor G.N. Purohit from the Department of Veterinary Gynecology and Obstetrics, College of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Rajasthan University of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Bikaner, Rajasthan, India. And I welcome you to my next YouTube lecture, the Immunomodulation for Fecundity Enhancement and Immunocontrol of the Fertility. The fecundity enhancement has been a matter of choice for both sheep and goats, and there had been development of some breeds of sheep and goat which are highly prolific. For example, the Garol sheep, which is known for its high prolificacy, and the Black Bengal goat, again, which is known for its high prolificacy or high fecundity. The reproductive performance of prolific breeds ranges between different flocks, populations, and years. This is an exhaustive list which mentions a lot of breeds, say for the Barbados Black Belly, age at first lambing is 14 to 22, lambing interval is 6 to 9 months, and the litter size is 2 to 2.3, so it is having a very high litter size. Then rest of the same breed, it is having a litter size of 1.5 to 2 at countries beyond Barbados. Then Prianjan, a breed from Indonesia, is having a litter size of 1.4 to 2.1, again comparatively very high. Then the Demon from Morocco is having a litter size of 1.8 to 2.7, and then the Swanka from USSR is having a litter size of 2 to 4. The Finnish Landrace from Finland is having a litter size of 2.7, again very high, and the Finnish Landrace elsewhere is having a litter size still had 2 to 3.2. The Romanov ewes of the USSR are having litter size of 2.6 to 3.3. Now, enhancement of the fecundity in sheep can be done by three approaches: the flushing or immunoneutralization of androstenedione, and inhibin immunogens. Feeding the ewe so she is gaining weight about 2 weeks before breeding is called flushing. Flushing may increase the lambing percentage by decreasing the number of eggs that the ewe ovulates. Flushing works best on thin ewes with a BCS of around 2, less than 2. The mature ewes respond better to flushing than yearlings. No benefit is seen in animals with excessive body condition scores or during the height of the normal breeding season. Overly thin animals also do not respond to flushing. Does and ewes that are maintained in very good condition on relatively high levels of nutrition throughout the year are less likely to respond to flushing. Now these are the pictures of the androstenedione vaccine, Androvax from MSD, Ovastim from Virbac, and Fecundin, Cooper's Animal Health, which is now withdrawn. The androstenedione vaccines are not recommended for merino ewes, and ewes are vaccinated 5 and 2 weeks before mating. This is repeated annually 2 weeks before mating. This reduces the estrogen and increases the FSH, thus increasing the ovulatory rates and thereby the fecundity. Then inhibin neutralization, inhibin is a hormone which reduces the FSH concentrations, and so neutralization of inhibin would result into increased ovulation rates. The inhibin conjugates and inhibin antiserum have been experimented in a large number of animal species, including sheep and goats, with fair to good results. Now we talk of the reproduction control vaccines. Reproduction control vaccines can serve two purposes: immunocontraception and immunonutrition. With immunocontraception, it prevents all sexual behavior in fertility, and antibodies against GnRH, raises antibodies against GnRH, so called the GnRH vaccines, useful for the domestic animals. Immunonutrients do not prevent sexual behavior, yet prevent fertilization. They are oocyte antigens. They react with the zona pellucida of many species and prevent fertilization, so useful for wild species. Now first we talk of the GnRH vaccines. For cattle, Vextrate is a GnRH vaccine popular in Northern Australia, and two doses are required. It was launched in 1980, yet withdrawn in 1996 because of being reactogenic. Then is a GnRH vaccine, Bopriva from Pfizer. It prevents estrus for 191 days, and two vaccines are given 3 to 7 weeks apart, which prevents estrus and ovulation for 3 months. This is useful for alpine, feedlot cattle and bulls. This is a picture of Bopriva. Bopriva may result in improvements in the following behaviors: fighting, sexual mounting, damage to infrastructure, pawing, digging and pasture damage, bellowing, dominance and territorial behavior. For female horses, there are 2-3 approaches which have been experimented. The first one is the Equity. Equity is a GnRH vaccine commercialized in 2001 in Australia. Then the placement of glass marble balls in the uterus have worked as a contraceptive, preventing estrus and conception in the bitch. A study was reported in which marbles were inserted into the uterus of mares for suppression of estrus. 35 mm glass marbles were sterilized, and subsequently a single large marble was placed into the uterus of each of the 12 mares, which prevented estrus and ovulation. Then the use of intrauterine devices have been experimented in horses with variable success rates. Then gonacon is a GnRH vaccine used for deer, bison, wild horses and camels. It is approved for use in some countries. For boars, Improvac is a vaccine which prevents the boar taint. Two doses, 4 and 8 weeks before slaughter, reduces the scatol and androstenedione, and hence the boar taint. This is a picture of the Improvac boar taint vaccine for male pigs for use. Then the porcine zona pellucida vaccine. Porcine zona pellucida vaccine prevents, it is an immunocontraception vaccine which is a surface antigen, and this blocks the entry of sperms in a oocyte. Spayvac is one of the commercially available porcine zona pellucida vaccine. The antibodies are formed on the zona pellucida, and this prevents the sperm from interacting with the zona pellucida. The sperm is thus not permitted to enter and fertilize the egg. Now, as far as the dogs are concerned, 30 million stray dogs are present worldwide, and the estimate also says that 20,000 people die of rabies annually. 35% of the world's human deaths occur because of rabies, especially in India, and they kill more people than the terror attacks. So canine gonadotrophic releasing factor immunotherapeutic has been developed for dogs. It is useful for immunocastration in male dogs for therapy of benign prostatic hyperplasia. The vaccine is repeated every 4 weeks, and this results into immunocontraception or immunocastration. Then Nutrisol, the zinc gluconate solution injected intratesticular, causes atrophy of the testes and permanent infertility. But because of the adverse reactions of testicular swelling and ulceration, this has not been in common practice. The most common approach useful approach would be a surgical sterilization of both the male and female stray dogs. For bitches, oral synthetic progesterones can be used for immunocontraception, but regular dosing is required. GnRH agonist implants, supralorin, can be used to prevent estrus and ovulation in bitches, but they need replacement every 6 months. It suppresses estrus. Each implant contains 4.7 milligram desloralin as desloralin acetate. Then GnRH agonist norepinephrine can be used and has been experimented in some of the species with variable results. Gonazone is injected subcutaneously in the region of the umbilicus. The implant may be administered to bitches from the age of 4 months, blocking reproductive function for an average of 12 months to 6 years. And blocking reproductive function on an average for 11 months. Then GnRH antagonist binds to and blocks GnRH receptors on the pituitary gland, and the suppression effect is instant. The common preparations of GnRH antagonists include cetrorelix and ganirelix, which are both administered as subcutaneous injections. These two are the GnRH antagonist, acyline, and the ganirelixum. Both have been used with variable success, but they are because of the other possible side effects, they have not become very popular. So thank you very much. Kindly share the video and subscribe to my YouTube channel Govind Narayan Purohit if you like them. Thank you.